So, is the PlayStation 5 Pro really necessary in today's landscape of gaming? The PlayStation 5 base is still relatively new at only being 3.5 years old. So, why do we need a new one? Is it necessary? Does it make sense? Let's find out. So the PlayStation 5 has been on the scene since late 2020, and it's been met with critical success as being arguably the most powerful console in this generation. So why do we need a pro version of that when the other one has potentially untapped resources? The PS5 Pro offers us a heftier GPU and a CPU with a new function to provide ray tracing capabilities on par with some PCs. Also, PlayStation 5 Pro has a host of other unmentioned details that have yet to be confirmed that promise a premium experience compared to your old PlayStation 5 base. Now, some people have mixed feelings about that. They feel like the PlayStation 5 is still relatively new, with only being 3.5 years in its life cycle, and has produced good games such as God of War Ragnarok, Spider-Man 2, and Baldur's Gate 3. However, some of these games are playable on your PC, and also met with the fact that when the PlayStation 5 base originally launched, it was kind of hard to obtain one. Reason being because of COVID, short production from Sony, and most importantly, let's talk about those damn scalpers. They caused a huge uproar and problem when the PlayStation 5 first launched. But with all that said, some people still have their PlayStation 4. And if you pair that with a good PC, you can still play a lot of Sony's premium titles for the PC and still play a lot of their current titles with your PlayStation 4. You will get a lesser version on your PlayStation 4, but it's still possible to play these games, especially if you have a PS4 Pro. So why do we need a PlayStation 5 Pro? Well, there are some merits to having one. For one, lots of people will probably get one because it will be, without a shadow of a doubt, the most powerful console that you can buy. And on top of that, it will address some issues as far as ray tracing and having more space for developers to develop games and have a higher version of the game than you would at the regular level with a base PS5. Also, another benefit of a PlayStation 5 Pro would be with the improvements for the PlayStation 5 base. Now, the base is already a powerful system. Now, with the added GPU, it will make you probably make you on par or close to with a low-end gaming PC, a gaming rig. It's not going to get you the performance of a 4000 series, no. But at the same time, it's a console, and consoles are convenient. A lot of people like to just put their games in, no loading, no problems with drivers, just put their games in and play them right out the gate. And on top of that, they have an interface where any old game you have, like older games, you might get an updated variation of it, okay? So if you're playing, let's say, an old like God of War Ragnarok, right? You play that on the PlayStation 5 Pro, it might add some features like ray tracing or, you know, faster load times or whatever. We don't know yet because we don't have the full specs of the PS5 Pro. Another selling point with that is it gives you more options. Like you have the upcoming PS5 Slim. You'll also have the PS5 Pro now to complement that. And then we can go back to the people who don't have a PlayStation 5 at all. And if you're in the market to buy one, you should definitely get the Pro, because we don't know the price yet, but if it's anything like past practices, it might be $100 to $150 more than the base version. And then you're future-proof for the PlayStation 5 as a whole, the life cycle of the system. However, it could be a double-edged sword of getting a PlayStation 5 Pro when you already have a base PlayStation 5. The PlayStation 5 is a very powerful system, and a lot of people feel like it's still in its infancy at only being 3.5 years old. In the same regard to the PlayStation 3, when it first started off, the games were hard to develop for. The system was hard to develop for. And the games came out and ran worse than they did on the Xbox 360, which is actually an inferior system to the PlayStation 3. But as the time went on in the generation, the PlayStation 3's potential was truly unlocked. It had beautiful games. I mean, it was like, I still to this day don't think the PlayStation 3 has been fully explored. but they moved on to the PlayStation 4. So PlayStation 3 earned its right to be a legacy console in, as far as the success. Same story with the PlayStation 4. And the PlayStation 4 story is even better because it started out the gate doing well. And it pretty much, in my opinion, and I love my Xbox, but the PlayStation 4 crushed the Xbox in that generation of gaming due to the sheer number of games it sold, the better versions it had, and it just did everything Xbox should have done. I mean, it ate Xbox's lunch. But moving on, and with that said, that shows that the PlayStation 4 was one of their most successful systems. Now, the PlayStation 5, a lot of people feel like we have yet to see that. We haven't been proven that yet. PlayStation 5 has not proved itself. And any console, in my opinion, in this current generation, has not stepped up to the plate and gave us great, good enough games for this generation. So with that said, PlayStation 5 still has a way to go. People don't feel like the PlayStation 5, you know, needs an upgrade right now because it hasn't really, you haven't unlocked the potential in the base version. Plus, it might bottleneck the developer's mindset with, we want to put, because Sony's going to ask for new features in the PlayStation 5 Pro to capitalize on the new GPU and CPU functions. But, you know, that's a, if you got the PlayStation 5 base, you're not going to, I mean, it's going to be a little better. I mean, at least that's what I'm thinking now. I haven't seen it yet, but it's going to be, you're going to be able to tell some differences, but it's not going to be like if you get a game on a PlayStation 4 and then you play the upgraded version on the PlayStation 5. I don't think it's going to be that big of a difference, but, you know, they're going to add the ray tracing and, you know, make the HDR better, but you have to ask yourself, is it worth that price? And it could split, you know, games. You get one version for the PlayStation base, one version for the PlayStation Pro. You know, some people might even look at it as a cash grab, you know. The PlayStation 5 base version has so much unlocked potential. So a lot of people are going to have a problem spending that money on the PlayStation 5 Pro. Now, maybe if it was like 6 or 7 years down the road, and even then, I don't know, maybe come out with a new system. I mean, back in the day, and it was kind of long, but the PlayStation 3 and the Xbox 360, they had a 10-year life cycle. Maybe too long, maybe some people might say. But it's still, they created good games for what the hardware was allotted. Whatever the hardware could pull off, they had the games that they peaked at the end. PlayStation 4, I think it did a really good job. I mean, did it peak? Maybe, it's debatable. But we know for sure the PlayStation 5 has not peaked. So it's going to be a tough sell for a lot of people. So that's just some of the caveats and some of the pluses of a PlayStation 5 Pro being released. Now it's going to come, we know that, but how is it going to sell? Is it going to be, I mean, and the scalpers, I mean, that's kind of off topic, but let's address these scalpers. I mean, and the demand and the availability of the PlayStation 5 Pro. Is it going to be just where I can go in and get one, or am I going to be on a waiting list, or how's that going to work out? So there's a lot of questions we don't know, and we won't know until we see the arrival of the PlayStation 5 Pro. All right, so let me know in the comments what you guys think. Is it necessary? Do we really need one? Are you going to get one? I mean, it can go a lot of ways. On one hand, people are saying that PlayStation 5 base hasn't been fully explored, and I would agree with that. We could do more with the PlayStation 5. Or on the other hand, people want the newest, best, and cutting edge technology with the PlayStation 5 Pro. So it has yet to be seen, and it's going to be interesting no matter what. So let me know in the comments below what you think. And with that, guys, that's going to do it for this video. As always, take care of your health, protect your inner peace, God bless, and we'll catch you on the next one.